Boker Tov, we're holding by Tu Bishvat. So we'd like to discuss, first of all, the Shechayonu. Shechayonu is usually a great confusion, especially today that we are so blessed. The halacha of Shechayonu is not based on our first time eating a new fruit, meaning a new fruit is based on the reality of the availability of the fruit on the market. So if your local store, for example, is Wesley Kosher or whatever the local store is, if they are carrying a fruit the entire year, there's no Shechayonu, even if it's the first time that we're eating it. So if it's twice a year that this fruit, for example, the watermelon, shows up in the market, you make a Shechayonu. So it could even be twice a year, as long as it's the renewal of the season, the availability in the store itself. And that's why today it's quite challenging. I was there yesterday, we had a jackfruit. I don't know if you ever heard of a jackfruit from India. Size of mamash, looks like a porcupine. Fascinating. So that's something that the stores usually don't carry. Either they carry because it's Tu Bishvat or Rosh Hashanah, then a person could recite Shechayonu. The order of the fruits, the chashivas, is based on the importance of the fruits, based on the pasuk itself of Eretz Chita Usora, meaning when it comes to the Shivas Haminim, the seven special species that the Eretz Yisrael was blessed with. Eretz Chita Usora, so wheat and barley come first. Then even though the pasuk says Gefen Tena V'Rimon, which means grapes, figs, and pomegranates, but since the second part of the pasuk that says Eretz Zeit Shemen U'Dvash, Zeit Shemen, the olives, and the Dvash, which is the dates, is closer to the word Eretz, it comes before Gefen Tena V'Rimon. So simple. The order is Chita Seoira, wheat, barley. Then you have Zeit Shemen, that means then you have olives, Dvash, dates, and then you have grapes, figs, and pomegranates. That's the order. Someone once asked me, and it's kedai to review this story, why is it so important, the order of things? Why is it so important that we are so detailed about the brachas? And the answer that I once gave, I was once giving a shiur to, it was a group of very special people, and there was one person there that wasn't really so connected to Judaism. This person actually was schlepped by his brother, who used to come every night. So let's call him Jordan. Anyway, Jordan's sitting in the shir. We're discussing the bracha of granola bars, which is actually quite complex. Which one is Adama, which one is Masonis, it depends how it's rolled. Anyway, for Mamish, maybe half an hour we're discussing the bracha, I don't remember. At some point, this person, Jordan, turns to me, like he raises his hand and says, Rabbi, is it so important? Why would you spend a half an hour trying to figure out the blessing on a granola bar? And I remember I was a little bit caught off guard, but the Ribbono Shel Olam gave me siyata dishmaya. And I turned to him and I said the following. I said, look, Jordan, you're not married yet, but when you get married, imagine your wife comes downstairs. You're about to go out and she had purchased a new dress. And she asks you, Jordan, what do you think about the dress? And this dress, many different colors, different patterns. So if you would say, looks nice, you just robbed your wife. You took away the opportunity to really appreciate how much time and effort your wife put into trying to purchase a dress to look good for you. But if you say, wow, look at the green and the red and the blue and how the blue matches your eyes and it brings out the beauty in you. That shows you care. That shows you appreciate. That shows you're connected more. And that's what brachas is. Brachas is a consciousness, a recognition. Hashem, I recognize everything that you're giving me. And to add a little bit more flavor, as we pointed out, there is such opportunity on a Kabbalistic level that the Mishnah Berurah, the Chafetz Chaim says in Siman Vav, that when we eat a food, as we pointed out, it's kedai just to realize that this is what's happening. There is nourishment for the body and there's nourishment from the soul, for the soul. And that means that there's spiritual sparks. So besides the chesed, the kindness that we said you bring out because you release certain souls that need to be released, but our soul itself gets nourished by the sparks of nourishment that are in this fruit. So enjoy the fruits, enjoy the blessings from the Ribbono Shel Olam, which will be zechataka, that our souls should be elevated, and all the souls should be elevated, and we should have true redemption on Tu Bishvat. Hatzlacha Rava.